So, for people that have never heard of Canoe Journey before, can you describe what happens at Canoe Journey?
Every tribe has a protocol that they do for the canoe journey. So they stand up and they sing their songs. They try to get much people active as possible. And some people wear traditional regalia from this side. And there's a lot of people who sing songs, and it's awesome.
Uplifting, we're able to teach our youth about the circle of life.
Coming together of all the tribes and sharing their cultures and their languages.
Tribal Journeys has always been a really empowering spiritual journey of sorts for
Canoe
me.
Journey is a great thing, I think. I would recommend it to almost anybody.
This is the beauty of our culture, and I'm right in it with both feet. Everybody should be. Come in here, come on in, join in. See what we got, it's beautiful.
I got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the bug.
Your name, your age, and your tribe?
I'm James from Soxwell Indian Tribe.
Mm-hmm.
I am 28 years of age. I forget how to say that in Lushootse. Okay.
And what has your role been so far in Canoe Journey?
Paddling, setting up tents, taking them down, paddling some more. Singing a couple protocol songs. I've been the main singer on the canoe.
So what does that mean?
I just started singing songs on the canoe.
Mm-hmm. And how many people are on each canoe normally?
There is a big difference on that. Some canoes can handle up to 23 people. Some canoes can handle up to 2.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And I guess a last question is, what is your favorite part of Canoe Journey, Ben?
It's split between the protocols that each tribe does and the actually paddling out in the water. It's so relaxing, and it makes you think about where we come from in the past and how long it took us from paddling from Soxhawatl to Olympia.
Mm-hmm.
Stephanie Spearing Aseya, that means medicine woman. My tribe is Tosistas, or Southern Cheyenne,
okay.
From Oklahoma.
And what was your experience, I guess, seeing any sort of like marine life along the way?
We saw a lot of ducks, the ones that dive down into the water and don't come up for like 10 minutes.
Uh-huh.
And we saw seals. Our canoe family actually named one Ed, because we swore he followed us all the way from Tulalip all the way down, because he just kept popping up, and it looked like the same seal, which probably wasn't. We saw a lot of seagulls. We saw a couple eagles. I saw a crab one time, and we almost tipped over because one of the guys got really excited about it. He was like, "What, crab?" We saw some fish, and a lot of mosquitoes.
Yeah.
We saw a lot of those.
So I feel like spending 2 weeks with the same people, you get to know each other a lot better, right?
Yes.
Do you feel like at the end of Canoe Journey, I guess that your relationships will change with people, or? Did you know
I
people well already?
I got one person to talk to me that wasn't talking at all to me. His name is Kevin. He's really, really shy. He's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I became better closer friends with my friend James, who's also in my same new family. And yeah, I've got to meet a bunch of people that seem to be really cool, and it's fun.
It's neat. So what's your favorite part about Canoe Journey now that you've landed?
That's a really good question. Soft seats are really nice. My favorite part of Canoe Journey. Huh. I don't know, I really enjoyed singing and learning the different songs that I got to sing. Mm-hmm. And I enjoyed it a lot.
Okay. So can you tell me your name? Your age and your tribal affiliation?
My name is Yayukton, and I'm Tlalum from Elwa, and I am 69 years old. Coming ashore. Well, it's, you can't, back in the day, old days, the way it's been explained to me, that when tribes would come to visit my tribe, mm-hmm. They would come in and then they would announce who they were and where they're from and who they were. Mm-hmm. And they would introduce, like I introduced myself, and then I would tell them that something like on Squatch or Chosh, come from Squatch and Allah. Very happy to be here in your land. And then just you ask him if you can come ashore out of respect, you don't just pull in. And you come in bow first, and we always have, war canoes, columns, we always traveled in war canoes. Just for that purpose, I guess.
Just in case they say no.
That's part of the story, is that once you requested permission to come ashore, and if they said no, then if you came in ball first, that's a sign of war, that you've come to make war with that tribe. Mm-hmm. But if they said, yeah, you're welcome, come ashore, then you turn your canoe around. And then you're back in it. We were able to teach our youth about the circle of life, and to teach them. Today, it's to teach them drug and alcohol free way, to how to live a clean life. Some of them that are here haven't been sober very long, you know. And I tell them about these people, these kids that. I said they sober up just for tribal journeys, and then when tribal journeys is all done, they go back to their old ways. I said, I don't want my crew to be that way. I said, when you become a warrior on my canoe and you become one of my paddlers, I don't want you just to be a warrior while you're on my canoe. I want you to be a warrior all year long.
So I guess I'm done with questions, but is there anything else that you feel like you want to share that you haven't gotten a chance to share with others around Indian Country about Canoe Journey?
We teach our youth about the circle of life and how it is. And every time we would land, we would have a full circle of everybody, a whole crew. Not only the pullers, but the people that travel along shore with us, and the people that are on the support boats. We have them all join us in the circle. And then we either have a feather or a talking stick, and then usually I will start, or one of our spiritual people will start with a prayer. And then I will talk, I will speak about our journey, and about our circle of life, and about the circle. And in our circle, we don't allow anybody to break it, to walk away from it. You know, everybody's standing, everybody has to stand. You can't sit down. But to try to teach them the things about the circle of life is something that all of you need to learn.
Well, my name at birth is Albert Little Bear Worthington. I've earned on tribal journeys the name of Beast, among many reasons, but I also sometimes go by Little Bear, and I'm 22 years old, and here I am, Tribal Journeys 2012. When I came on to Tribal Journeys in 2006, I was 16, I was a boy, and I had a lot of growing up to do, and a lot of maturing to do, and I hadn't done really any of it, and I was really interested in playing around and not doing what needed to get done, and Tribal Journeys has helped me grow up a lot, both spiritually and maturely. I've grown in a lot of ways that could otherwise probably not be achieved. Mm-hmm. I've learned to understand and respect the land and the water and everything that comes with them, and that it's okay to ask for help if you need it, is a big thing. And then on the other side of that same coin, it's important that when someone else needs your help, that you help them as well. And that kind of ties into the camaraderie that I spoke of earlier with Tribal Journeys. No matter what, if you need help, it's always there. Whether it be from your own canoe family or from someone else that you've traveled with or someone that you've never even seen before, there's always someone that's willing to help you if you need help.
I'm Jose. I am traveling with the Blue Heron Canoe. This father is Mike Evans, Dita Hallcade. I am Snohomish, Cherokee, Chippewa, Sioux, and Blackfeet. I learned is to be patient. A big thing that I've learned this canoe journey and is to ask questions. It's never a bad thing. People say that there is no such thing as a dumb questions unless you're being immature. Yeah. But still, it's good to ask questions because it's how people see how you're opened up to them. They know that you want to be there, that they do have your attention. That you want to participate with them. One thing that I like to see that goes on is all the people that are here are friendly most of the time. You could get along with almost anyone that you talk to. I've met so many people this journey that I would never have thought of speaking to before. I just spoke to them because I know they were on journey, and they're my people, our people. The native people, and it's easy to get along with one another. It's a lot of what we do is traveling together. We usually start 2 weeks ahead, my canoe family, pre-hand before the final landing. And we travel usually with a group, a number of other canoes. Last year we traveled with 80 canoes coming from all sorts of other directions, from Alaska to the East Coast, like New York, Hawaii. I've met people from all over the world that I would never have met if it were not for Canoe Journey. Canoe Journey is a great thing, I think. I would recommend it to almost anybody. But be aware, you will get tired, but it's all worth it in the end. It really is.
Yeah.
And the people you meet, it's just a wonderful thing.